Welcome back to Floyd Central as we're going to get ready for the Class 2A Boys 6 and 8 Championship. It's going to be Pike Central and Magoffin County. The teams are on the floor warming up right now, Justin. And Pike County comes into this game tonight with a 9-4 record. They've got a couple of players averaging in double figures, you could say. They're averaging 20 points a game. Yeah. Jalen Rigdon, 24.8 points a game, just a little under 25 points. And his specialty is free throw shooting. He's made 64 free throws already on the season, 106 two-point field goals. Second leading scorer is Jaden Stewart, 22.5 points a game. He has made 36 three-pointers on the season, only made 16 free throws, 73 two-point buckets. As far as rebounding goes, Rigdon with 8 and also Stewart with 8. So those are the two players that Magoffin County is going to have to watch tonight. Jalen Rigdon and Jaden Stewart. Third leading scorer drops off to Peyton Compton, only averaging 6 points a game.
Yeah, they'll go as far as those two can take them. And, you know, I mentioned I was at the game the other night and the boys played Pike Central. And Rigdon and Stewart put on a show. They absolutely were tough to stop. I can't think of I remember the number. I think it was 14. I thought it was 14. Maybe it's 4. That's who it was. Blake Adams only averages 3.4 points a game. Hit 3 3-pointers in the fourth quarter in a very close game. I mean, he absolutely just broke the back of Floyd Central. So, but now Stewart and Rigdon that's about as good a duo as you'll find in the 15th region.
Well, you talk about Atkins for the season, and these are up-to-date stats. He's 5-10 from behind the three-point line.
Well, 3 of them came the other night. And they were absolutely huge, huge, big-time shots.
Pike Central averaging 64 points a game, 25 rebounds. And as far as three-pointers, they're averaging making 6 three-pointers a game.
Yeah, they're Stewart can – he hit 4 the other night, all in the first half, but he's got range when he steps across half court. He can pull it up. And the same for Magoffin County here. Barnett, he can shoot it from 27, 28 feet as well. So Magoffin County comes in at 6-5 on the season, and they've had some injuries, so they haven't been really at full strength a lot this year. They're led in scoring by Aiden Barnett, 19 points a game, Zane Whitaker with 14, Ben Lafferty 11, Grayson Whitaker with 12, and then it kind of falls off from there. Walker Russell, with 4 points a game. Barnett is he's only played 8 of their 11 games, so he's been nursing a hamstring injury. But he comes in, he's made 54 field goals. He's shooting 47% from the field. From the three-point line, he's only 8 of 27, so 29% from the three-point line. Grayson Whitaker, he's hit 22 threes, 22 for 61 for 36%. And rebounding-wise, Zane Whitaker, Ben Lafferty, and Aiden Barnett all at about 6 rebounds a game. Grayson Whitaker with 3, Ethan Salyer with 2. As a team, they are 46% from the three-point line, or that's from the field, 29% from the three-point line, and 70% from the free throw line. So kind of even match stat-wise. I really think we're in for a really good game. They only average 54 points a game, and that being in part to, they share the ball so well. They don't really, unless Barnett goes off for a really big night, the roughly 10, 11, 12 points a game for those big four. So it's going to be interesting. I think we're in for a battle. The first game didn't let us down, so hopefully this one doesn't either.
Exactly right. So we're going to send it back to the station. When we return, we'll have the starting lineups and the tee-off of tonight's game between Magoffin County and Pike Central. This year in the Mountain Sports Network.
When life's unfortunate events happen, we sometimes see people at their worst. That's why we make it our goal to give them our best. If you've been involved in an auto accident, have a workers' compensation, Social Security, or SSI claim, you need an attorney with proven results. You need John Earl Hunt.
I'm attorney John Earl Hunt. I believe in the U.S. Constitution, and I support the American flag. I'm a country lawyer. I'd be honored to represent you in your case. I'll treat you right. I'll do the best I can to help you.
Say, if it tastes good, it can't be good for you. We beg to differ. Now open Newday Nutrition in the Weddington Plaza, Pikeville. Your home for delicious, healthy, energy-boosting teas, specialty iced and hot coffees, and scrumptious protein shakes that serve as a meal replacement. Try our protein bars or tasty protein coffees. And coming soon, baked goods. Open Monday through Friday, 7 till 6, Saturday, 9 till 5. Curbside service and delivery are available. Call 637-2120 or visit Newday Nutrition. Center.com.
Buying a home, it's likely the largest purchase you'll ever make. And choosing a bank is one of your most important decisions. Choose wisely. Choose Community Trust Bank to get you home. With over a century of mortgage experience, we're committed to the highest standards of personalized service. For strengths only a community bank can offer, look to Community Trust Bank. Building communities built on trust.
We offer speeds up to 1 gig, so you can game, stream, surf, and shop on multiple devices without slowing down. Get started now at imctv.com or give us a call at 606-478-9406 for more info.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Howard Family Pharmacy offers fast and friendly service and drive-thrus at both locations at the intersection in Allen and off Route 80 at Eastern.
Today, reliable internet is crucial for everyone to thrive. Gearheart Broadband gets it. If you or someone in your household qualifies, we can help you access the new affordable connectivity program, allowing Gearheart Broadband to reduce your broadband bill by up to $30 per month. Visit imctv.com/ACP to learn more about this new opportunity. Gearheart Broadband, here to keep you connected.
I'm Jennifer Reynolds, and I've been a state farm agent for over 20 years here in Pikeville. We offer all the products and services available through State Farm Insurance. You'll receive all the benefits of a state farm agent in a convenient location while being serviced by my licensed staff in a friendly office environment. Call us if you need a quote for auto insurance, fire, life, or health, or if you need information on our financial services product. Our commitment is to you, our client. Walk in, call in, or click in anytime, day or night.
Back here at Floyd Central, about 2 minutes away from the championship of the Section 8 2A State Championship. And we've got two 15th region opponents. Pike Central had to win two games to get here. They beat Boyd County on the opening night, then Floyd Central on Wednesday. Magoffin County got a bye in the first round, only had to beat Lawrence County, and they put it all over Lawrence County here on Thursday night. So been a pretty good tournament so far, and I anticipate this being two of the teams that'll be at the Appalachian Wireless Arena, I would imagine, you know, barring some upsets and things of that nature. But I feel like these two teams, this is a good mid-season matchup to kind of let you know where you stand.
And the same as the girls, the winner of Section 8 will play Section 6. And same as the girls, the boys is Rowan County and Greenup County on that game also. So it's Rowan County boys and girls against the Greenup County boys and girls. Got some viewers watching in from South Carolina and also from Florida. Rooting on the Hawks. And somebody here says the winner will play Mason County in the state tournament, but that's not what we've got as far as our brackets go. So,
yeah, these where they do sections instead of the regions, and obviously it doesn't matter what region you're in because Greenup's in the 16th, and as well as Boyd County, and Boyd County's playing up here, and Greenup in a different section, so.
Well, you know, Section 6, who they play in Mason County is in Section 6.
Right.
So, our information might not be right or whatever, but the viewer says that that's exactly who they'll be playing in Section 6. You got Bath County, Estill County, Fleming County, Greenup County, Mason County, Powell County, and Rowan County. And we're about ready for our starting lineups in this championship game, Section 8. 2A Championship, Pike Central, and Magoffin County.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the campus of Floyd Central High School for tonight's Class 2A Section 8 Basketball Tournament. Tonight's championship game is between the home team on the scoreboard, the Hawks from Pike County Central. And the visitors on the scoreboard, the Hornets from Magoffin County. Let's meet the starting lineups. First for the visitors on the scoreboard, Magoffin County. At guard, number 2, Aiden Barnett. At forward, number 23, Ben Lafferty. At center, number 14, Zane Whitaker. Number 10, Ethan Salyer. And at guard, number 5, Grayson Whitaker. The Hornets are coached by head coach Scott Castle. Now for the home team on the scoreboard, Pike County Central. At guard, number 0, Jalen Rigdon. At guard, number 2, Peyton Compton. At forward, number 21, Jaden Stewart. At guard, number 4, Blake Adams. And at guard, number 12, Isaac Reynolds. The Hawks are coached by head coach Eric Ratliff. Tonight's officials are Cody Sloan, Marty Gibson, and David Fields.
And that's our starting lineups of tonight's game, man. The Section 6 winner is Mason County. The viewer that gave us that information said he does the radio for Mason County, and they beat Estill County today 78-58. So it will be Mason County that the winner of this game will play.
Pike Central with the excellent student section down here.
And there's the tip, and Magoffin County will control it. Barnett with it into the front court. He drives down the lane, shot up, and rolls off. No good. Tipped around. Stewart comes off with it for Pike Central. He'll give it over to Rigdon.
Nice move by Barnett to start. Couldn't finish.
Rigdon drives. Hands it off. That's Compton with it. Here's Rigdon on the weave at the top of the circle, gives it out to Stewart. He's going to fire the long three off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound comes off to Magoffin County's Salyer. Over to Barnett. Pike Central into man-to-man, Justin.
Yeah, both teams man-to-man. Be some good matchups out here.
Whitaker with it. That's Zane Whitaker. You've got two Whitakers.
Yes.
You've got Grayson and Zane. Starting for Magoffin County. Zane Whitaker, and they'll look to get it to Barnett.
Good patience here by Magoffin County.
Ben Lafferty with it, looking for help. Puts it on the floor, gives it to Barnett. Free throw line jumper, good.
That's tough, because he had a hand right in it. He had to kind of double pump that just a little bit there. That's, yeah, that's a good-looking shot.
And Barnett, just a senior. I mean, just a junior.
Yeah, he's already scored 2,000 points. Jalen Rigdon scored his 2,000th point in the last game.
And he scored his first points of the night as he breaks free on the baseline, puts it up, and we're tied at two.
Right on cue.
Two 2,000-point scorers
juniors
on the floor.
And they're both
juniors. Both of them juniors. Yeah. You don't see that very often.
No. Nice pass.
And here's a
good
nice
play,
and Zane Whitaker puts it in. 4-2, Magoffin County. Rigdon into the front court. He'll come. He's got number 10, Salyer, on him.
Ooh.
Pike Central works it back over to Rigdon on the baseline. Gets free. Reverse layup. Misses it. Rebound comes off to Grayson Whitaker. Into the corner. Drives down the baseline, lefty, and he has it taken away.
Rigdon got to the glass two times in a row. Finished one, didn't the other.
And he's quick enough. He can get to the rim pretty well when he wants to. He'll stop and shoot a 15-footer, no good. Rebound comes off, that's Arnett with it. Or, excuse me, Barnett. He goes across over to Grayson Whitaker. Whitaker looking for a screen, gets it Lafferty, and now they'll go back over to Salyer. Barnett with it now. And again, being very patient.
Here's
the three, and it's an air ball. That was Grayson Whitaker, and it'll go to Pike Central.
Yeah, good patience and, you know, kind of maybe a settle there for that three. But
Pike Central working in the front court with it. This is Adams. Rigdon. In the corner, Stewart. And nice defense that time by Lafferty. And Stewart takes it to the baseline and off the glass and in. We're tied at four.
Nice step through.
4:15 to go here, first quarter.
Give the pump fake. Halfway through the first quarter, and it's just 4-4. But I like the action, though, on both ends.
Yes. There's a near steal, but Rigdon gets it over. That's Lafferty on the baseline, and he's going to be fouled.
Number 12, Isaac Reynolds, to be his first. That's the first foul of the game.
First foul of the game, and we're one tick under 4 minutes here in the first quarter.
Which we saw a lot of that in the girls' game. You know, they let the action.
Same crew.
Yeah, yeah.
Lafferty misses the first free throw. We have one more. And both came up short. Stewart come up with the rebound.
It's like a little zone action here, this time from Magoffin County.
It's going to be a 1-2-2 half-court trap. Here's Stewart. Might have got away with the shove with the feet. Defender falls down. He fires a three. No good. Lafferty with the rebound. Into the front court comes Salyer with it for Magoffin County. Gives it over to Barnett. Into the corner. Long three, up and good. Grayson Whitaker. First three-point bucket of the game by either team, and Magoffin County takes the 7-4 lead.
That zone there.
Here's Rigdon. Free throw line jumper, no good. Rebound comes off the left. He's knocked away by Rigdon, picked up a Pike Central. Stewart, long three, count it. We're tied at 7. These two teams are matching blows right now.
Yeah, if you're Magoffin County, you got to clean that up. You can't give that second chance opportunity. Nice move.
Nice drive by Barnett. He lifts his defender glued to the floor.
He's smooth. He's so strong, too. When he got to the glass there, took the contact. Easy finish.
9-7, Magoffin County. There's the baseline drive. Ball kicked back out. Taken away, Barnett. And he's going to be fouled from behind. He throws it up trying to get the two shots, but they say no, it's on the floor. Got number 5 for Pike Central in lineup. That's Caden Crum. And there was another number came in. It didn't get hit.
34.
34, Peyton Owens. Barnett will bring it in for Magoffin County. Got it into Whitaker. He takes the pass back. Now gets it over to Lafferty.
Got Whitaker on the post.
Barnett, spin move. Step back, baseline, no good.
Tough
rebound
shot.
Comes off Pike Central. Number two, that's Compton, and he's going to be fouled.
On Salyer. Only the first team foul on Magoffin County.
And the inbound pass comes into Rigdon. 2:12 left. Here's a three out of the corner. Count it. That's number two, Peyton Compton.
Second three-pointer for Pike Central.
And Pike Central takes the lead 10-9. Whitaker hands off to Sayer. Here's the three up, no good. Rebound by Whitaker, shot no good. And he's fouled, go to the line for two. That is Zane Whitaker with the rebound.
Foul on Jaden Stewart.
First free throw rattles in.
Number three in for Ben Lafferty. That's Reed Meadows. And zero, Walker Russell.
One more free throw for Zane Whitaker. We're tied at 10 and make it 11-10 now. Magoffin County as Whitaker knocks down both free throws. Pike Central's Rigdon down in the corner. That was Crum with it. Here's a drive in the middle and try to get it over. Ooh. And there's going to be a foul called. Try to get it to Peyton Owens.
Number two, Barnett, be his first.
Here's Stewart to Rigdon. He loses it, picks it up. Got Barnett on him. That's a good matchup.
Yes, absolutely. Barnett just picked up that foul. You don't want to pick up your second here.
Here's Rigdon looking for a screen. Can't get it. Compton with it. Ball loose on the floor and thrown away. Barnett with the steal. Gets it down in the corner. There's Whitaker. Baseline drive. Shot up and nice roll. Grayson Whitaker.
He looks like he's a scorer.
He does.
He's looking for his shot.
And Magoffin County up by three. There's Stewart.
Ooh.
And Rigdon nearly with the tip in, but Pike Central comes away with it. Stewart, three. No. And going high for the rebound that time, Zane Whitaker. Barnett.
Ooh.
And got tangled up a little bit. Ball going out of bounds. Oh, no, going to be a foul call.
Oh, you call it? Oh, that's two on Stewart. Got to get him out. 36 seconds to go. Got to get him out. Yeah, okay.
And now he'll come out. Number four comes in for him. That's Blake Adams back in the lineup for Pike Central. 13-10, Magoffin County with the lead. 30 seconds left here in the first quarter. And there's a hard drive. And
Whitaker.
Beautiful drop step that time by Zane. Whitaker puts it in off the glass. Magoffin County up by 15-10. I'll get it right in a minute. Out of the corner, three. Count it.
Big one.
Blake Adams. That's your man you
that
saw about the other night.
Yeah, he hit three big ones in the fourth quarter against Floyd Central the other night. That's the third three-pointer for Pike Central in the first quarter.
Barnett topped the circle three, no good. But
rebound
up and in.
Big.
Number three, Reed Meadows. And
big
it's
shot. Big
17-13
rebound.
Here at the end of one. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
winter upon us, you can count on Gearheart Broadband to keep your home connected. Gearheart TV connects you to a world of entertainment with great digital features, DVR, and lots of HD channels. High-speed internet connects you to the web faster than ever. And next-gen digital phone connects friends and family for less. If you don't have all three connections yet, it's a great time to bundle up for the winter. Call our friendly customer service team and start saving today with Gearheart Broadband.
You plan on being there for her for a long, long time. For recitals, soccer games, graduations, until she's a grown-up of her own. But what if you can't be there? Protect what matters most. Talk to a Kentucky Farm Bureau agent about life insurance.
Come push me, Daddy.
Talk to agent John Greer Hunt today at 606-791-2122.
Back here at Floyd Central, 17-13, Magoffin County on top. Really good action for both teams. I mean, you can tell this is a high-level game right here. You got everybody with all the players on the floor are getting after it. You got big-time shots getting made. Pike Central made three threes in the first quarter. Magoffin County with only one.
Well, you've got a couple of, high scorers on each team, but yeah. Both teams has got good supporting cast.
Yes, and they both played well that first.
Pike Central has it. Start this second quarter. And here's a steal, trying to get it to Rigdon. And putting it up and in, number 10, Ethan Salyer.
His first bucket of the game.
19-13. He's challenging Rigdon a little bit. Rigdon stepped back and caught him for the walk.
Yeah, I'm not sure that was a walk. I mean, that step back, they've been doing that for
years.
Yeah, that's a normal shot in today's game. I thought it was a walk 6 or 7 years ago, but now you just kind of take it for granted.
Yeah,
you know?
go with the flow on it. Barnett with it for Magoffin County. Wow, and he blows right by his man, goes in double teamed at the rim, can't get it to go. Rebound comes off. That was Adams for Pike Central, and then they throw it away as try to get it down to number 23, Brad Billiter, into the lineup.
Rigdon a little flustered here. Two turnovers.
Well, they're putting some heavy pressure on him on the
Well, Magoffin County's got good athletes to match up here.
Magoffin County working with it in the front court. Whitaker. And there's a little runner in the lane. It comes up way short. Rebound. Pike Central. That was Salyer with the shot. And on the other end, Rigdon's shot no good. Salyer comes off the rebound. Gets it up to Barnett. Round two men. Got hammered. No call. Pike Central comes up with it.
A lot of contact there. Barnett's so strong, too. You know it had to be some pretty good contact to knock
him loose from.
Yeah.
Here's Rigdon. In the lane, kicking it back out. Three in the air. No good. That was number three, Cameron Stafford, in the lineup for Pike Central. Magoffin County with the rebound. Whitaker. Lafferty back into the lineup, gets it over to Barnett. Here's Lafferty, baseline drive, and splits the double team, puts it in. And Magoffin County now is with the 8-point lead, 21-13.
Magoffin County's got six players to score already. That's a good sign. That's sharing the ball.
Well, you said earlier in the pregame, that they didn't have a lot of high scores other than Barnett. They like to share the basketball, yeah. And they're showing that here in the first half. Here's Rigdon on the drive, splits a double team. Floater in the lane, no good. Rebound Barnett. Rigdon is a little cold right now from the field.
I think.
Didn't know exactly what to do with it.
Yeah. I think if you're Pike Central here, you might want to think about Stewart, see if you can steal a couple minutes.
Yeah.
Kind of like Lawrence County did with Atkins in that first game.
Well, he's got the two fouls. Yeah. He's on the bench right now. They can't afford to get too far down, though, before they can get him back in the game.
Yeah, because that offense, they need his offense.
And there's the ball knocked loose, but picked up by Brad Billiter, puts it in for two. First bucket in a long time for Pike Central.
Yeah, first points of the quarter.
4:50 left here in the first half. Salyer with it for Magoffin County. And beautiful lob, but missed by Whitaker, and then you got a double dribble.
That's the second time they ran that play, and both times it worked out great. Just didn't get the finish on that one. But
yeah, made the first one.
Yeah. I watched him in warm-ups now. He can, I don't know why they're not throwing that at the rim. He can absolutely slam it.
Yeah.
I mean, in warm-ups, he was.
And they get it into him. He drives it, stops, eight-footer up, and one. Great body control that time by Zane Whitaker, a junior. And he'll go to the line to try to complete the three-point play.
Foul on Stafford.
And Whitaker makes the free throw.
Give him nine already.
And that's where the lead stands, 24-15. 4:20 left first half. Right Central working with it. Reverse, getting to the corner. Adams, three, no good. Battle for the rebound, and it's going to stay with Pike Central. Peyton Owens looks like coming back in the ball game for the Hawks. Pike Central will get it in on the side and come in to Rigdon. Here's Rigdon down the lane to the bucket and blocked out of bounds. It's going to stay with Pike Central.
Yeah,
big,
I mean that
big block by Zane Whitaker.
Yeah, he was waiting on him when he got there. The help came.
He might have said a little something, you know, a little woofing going on. The official stepped over and talked to him, and now
got another conversation.
Got another
out
conversation out front. That's between Salyer and Rigdon, and Salyer has been in Rigdon's grill all night.
Ooh, nice move.
There's Adams, and he puts it up and in, 12-foot. Off the baseline.
Nice move.
24-17. That's
his field
point.
Yeah, needed that. So they can dig in and get a stop.
Barnett gives it over to Salyer. Lafferty with it. Barnett goes down low. Whitaker, Zane Whitaker, working hard. Turn around, baseline, fall away, up and in.
Ain't much you can do with that. Give him 11.
He's got that good hops on him, like you said, and then he shoots his shots, really extends his arms real high.
He's at least 6'4", too. I mean, he's got good height. Starting with a pretty good base.
They've got him listed at 6'5".
Yeah, that's.
Mike Central working with it, looking for a shot. Here's Rigdon. They know who number zero is.
Yes.
Long three out of the corner, no. And Whitaker comes off the rebound, gets hit in the face. It's accidentally.
Yeah.
And Brad Billiter will pick up the foul. And Rigdon looks like he's trying to shake it off. He's still been over a little bit, got hit in the eye maybe. And bench asks if they can look at him, and they do. Clock rests with 2:43 left first half. It's 26-17 Magoffin County.
Pike Central just trying to hang on here. You know, it's easy to key in on Rigdon when Stewart's not in the game too.
Yes.
You know, being that other big scorer.
Pike Central was 16 fouls too.
Yeah.
Also, Magoffin County only two. They go down low to Lafferty, kicks it back out on top. Three in the air, no good by Salyer. Rebound comes off Pike Central. Rigdon up court. Adams on the floor to the bucket, and It's blocked by Lafferty. Barnett into the corner. Whitaker, no. And Rigdon goes up and gets the rebound. And he's going to break free, takes it to the bucket, puts it up and in.
Nice one. Could have been an and one there, too.
Could have been. Jalen Rigdon cuts the lead to 7, 26-19. And Rigdon with the near steal knocks it out of bounds. It's going to stay with Magoffin County.
Whitaker.
Reed Meadows back in from Magoffin
County.
Comes in
for Zane Whitaker there. That eye must be hurting him a little bit because he's not got any fouls, which Magoffin County's only got two for the game.
Yes. And there's Barnett down the lane, and before the shot.
It's going to be free throws either way.
I thought they was going to call a walk because, see, the officials are convert. And now they're going to call the block Peyton Owens. And that's going to be the 1-1. 1:46 left first half. It's 26-19, Magoffin County. Aiden Barnett will be at the line shooting the 1-1. Is this the first free throws for Magoffin County?
No. Whitaker made two, and Ben Lafferty missed two. He missed, went 0 for 2 there early in the game.
And Barnett misses it. Don't see that very often.
No.
Pike sent the rebound, Rigdon with it. Got three men chasing him.
Yeah. He's got some space here. I'd let him operate. No pick. Just let him operate.
Just clear the floor with him. He's got Salyer on him. Adams comes out and takes it for Pike Central.
Yeah, I think you're clogging it up a little bit for him there. Just kind of, I mean, he's got the room right now. There you go.
Yeah, and coach telling him to spread out, let him have some room, man. He pulls up at the free throw line, no good. Rebound comes off Grayson Whitaker. And Rigdon deflected the pass. It's stolen by Compton, and he's fouled going to the bucket. Number three with the foul, that's Reed Meadows.
Only their third team foul under a minute to go, which they've, you know, it's Pike Central's not really put a lot of pressure on them.
No, it's been a good clean game both ways.
Absolutely.
Peyton Compton at the line with the 1-1. Or no, he hits two shots. He found an active shooter. Misses it.
That is their first free throw attempt of the game.
And they need these to stay close. It's 26-19. We're under a minute.
Yeah, you got to finish this quarter here, too, if you're Pike Central.
And gets the second one to fall.
Because you've survived with Stewart on the bench here. I mean, you're only down six.
Yes.
Good call by coach. So, but you got to finish here.
Yes, you still got 50 seconds left. They need a stop. If they'd stop and just go in down six, it'd be a win for them.
Yes, absolutely.
Here's Barnett with it. Gets it over to Whitaker. Lafferty inside. Barnett breaks free, and he's going to be fouled. It's going to be a 1-1.
Two on Adams. Barnett, he missed
the front end of 1-1 the last trip down.
Gets another bonus, gets another chance here.
...26-20, 32.6 seconds left, first half, and Barnett makes the free throw. That looks more like his stroke than that first one.
Yes. Yeah, if you can survive here, if he makes this one, the last shot of the half, and if you could convert on it, you know, keep yourself in that 5-6 range.
And he makes them both. And got number 14 coming in for him. That's coming in for number three.
Yeah, for Meadows.
Meadows, that's the
Zane Whitaker coming
That's the enforcer at the rim.
Absolutely. Yeah, he changes a couple shots, I'm sure, when you go in looking at that guy.
28-20. Magoffin County with the lead. Pike sent the ball, and here goes Rigdon, and Whitaker had the block, but they got him with the body, they said, so he's going to be Rigdon going to line for two. Oh, no, they call it on number 23, Lafferty.
Yeah, Lafferty.
Okay.
Rigdon's only got 4 points, coming in averaging 24.
He'll have two. Makes the first. .9 seconds left, 28-21, as it stands right now. Rigdon will have one more free throw. And he rolls the second one in also. Back to the 6-point lead. Magoffin County will have a chance for the last shot. Grayson Whitaker with it. Here's Lafferty, and they're going to go to Barnett, and he breaks free on the baseline.
Got the
back cut. Puts it up and in. Rigdon, long shot at the horn, no, and at the half, it's 30-22, Magoffin County. We'll send it back to the station. Be back shortly for some halftime stats and comments. This is a Class 2A Boys State Section 8 Championship on Intermountain Sports Network.
They say if it tastes good, it can't be good for you. We beg to differ. Now open Newday Nutrition in the Weddington Plaza, Pikeville. Your home for delicious, healthy, energy-boosting teas, specialty iced and hot coffees, and scrumptious protein shakes that serve as a meal replacement. Try our protein bars or tasty protein coffees. And coming soon, baked goods. Open Monday through Friday, 7 till 6, Saturday, 9 till 5. Curbside service and delivery are available. Call 637-2120 or visit NewdayNutritionCenter.com.
Buying a home, it's likely the largest purchase you'll ever make. And choosing a bank is one of your most important decisions. Choose wisely. Choose Community Trust Bank to get you home. With over a century of mortgage experience, we're committed to the highest standards of personalized service. For strengths only a community bank can offer, look to Community Trust Bank. Building communities built on trust.
We offer speeds up to 1 gig, so you can game, stream, surf, and shop on multiple devices without slowing down. Get started now at imctv.com or give us a call at 606-478-9406 for more info.
Howard Family Pharmacy offers fast and friendly service and drive-throughs at both locations at the intersection in Allen and off Route 80 at Eastern.
Today, reliable internet is crucial for everyone to thrive. Gearheart Broadband gets it. If you or someone in your household qualifies, we can help you access the new affordable connectivity program, allowing Gearheart Broadband to reduce your broadband bill by up to $30 per month. Visit imctv.com/ACP to learn more about this new opportunity. Gearheart Broadband, here to keep you connected.
I'm Jennifer Reynolds, and I've been a state farm agent for over 20 years here in Pikeville. We offer all the products and services available through State Farm Insurance. You'll receive all the benefits of a state farm agent in a convenient location while being serviced by my licensed staff in a friendly office environment. Call us if you need a quote for auto insurance, fire, life, or health, or if you need information on our financial services product. Our commitment is to you, our client. Walk in, call in, or click in anytime, day or night.
With winter upon us, you can count on Gearheart Broadband to keep your home connected. Gearheart TV connects you to a world of entertainment with great digital features, DVR, and lots of HD channels. High-speed internet connects you to the web faster than ever. And next-gen digital phone connects friends and family for less. If you don't have all three connections yet, it's a great time to bundle up for the winter. Call our friendly customer service team and start saving today with Gearheart Broadband.
You plan on being there for her for a long, long time. For recitals, soccer games, graduations, until she's a grown-up of her own. But what if you can't be there? Protect what matters most. Talk to a Kentucky Farm Bureau agent about life insurance.
Come play!
Talk to Agent John Greer Hunt today at 606-791-2122.
Gearheart Security's Smart Home Holiday Bundles are here. Combine blazing fast broadband and home security to save some cash, plus a free security camera. We also offer home security takeovers, Life Sentry, camera-only specials with financing available. Find out more at GearheartSecurity.com/specials or call us at 1-800-264-1730. Stop by our new location in Harold to enter to win a free Yeti cooler.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Welcome back to Floyd Central High School. We're at the half of the championship game of the boys 2A championship. 30-22 Magoffin County over Pike Central at the half. And Justin, Magoffin County just come out and was steady throughout the whole first half. Pike Central's Stewart, their second leading scorer and best three-point shooter, got in some early foul trouble and only played about a half of a quarter in that first half.
Yeah, and, you know, Magoffin County was very physical there with Rigdon out front and, you know, Stewart on the bench. It's easy to focus on Rigdon, and their offense kind of showed. I mean, only 22 points in the first half. Not a regular showing for Pike Central, and, yes. You know, hopefully Stewart can get out here and kind of showcase his skills a little bit and the second half a little bit more. For Magoffin County, well, you know, kind of what you would think their scoring would look like, but they had six people score in the first half, led by Zane Whitaker. He had 11, Aiden Barnett with 8, Ben Lafferty with 2, Grayson Whitaker with 5, Ethan Salyer with 2, and Reed Meadows with that big offensive rebound and putback right at the end of the first quarter. Kind of snuck in there and stole one. I had them with 12 rebounds and Pike Central with 10. So they got the edge on the glass as well. For Pike Central, led in scoring by Jalen Rigdon. He had 6 points. Jaden Stewart with 5. Peyton Compton with 4. Blake Adams with 5. And 2 for Brad Builder. And they were 3 for 4 from the free throw line. And Magoffin County was 5 for 8 from the free throw line. So going to be interesting to see how what kind of adjustments are made. Your Magoffin County, I mean, just kind of going downhill, being physical. And if you're Pike Central, you need to get Stewart and Rigdon going.
Yes.
I mean, they've only got 11 points between the two of them. And they're at about 50.
They come
50,
in averaging like, about 45 or 50, yeah. You know, coming into the game. You're exactly right. Of course, Adams picked up a little slack there for
– Yeah, absolutely.
Stewart, what time he's on the bench, he hit a three-pointer. And I think
Peyton Compton had a three-pointer too,
I think.
Yeah.
So, you know, trying to pick up a little bit. And, of course, you know, just like I said, Stewart, he'll be back in this second half, we're sure, to try to get help his team – overcome his 8-point lead here at the half. So we'll send it back to the station. Be back shortly for the start of the second half. 30-22 Magoffin County over Pike Central at the half. This is Intermountain Sports Network.
You're on the move every day. You're mobile, and so is Community Trust Bank. Now you've got one-touch access to your accounts. No need to remember or update passwords. Make a deposit with a click, not a pen. No deposit slip and no line. And get that morning cup of joe without the hassle, without the wait. Community Trust Bank is dedicated to making your banking experience secure, fast, and easy. Don't wait. Go mobile with Community Trust Bank. Building communities built on trust.
When life's unfortunate events happen, we sometimes see people at their worst. That's why we make it our goal to give them our best. If you've been involved in an auto accident, have a workers' compensation, Social Security, or SSI claim, you need an attorney with proven results. You need John Earl Hunt.
I'm attorney John Earl Hunt. I believe in the U.S. Constitution, and I support the American flag. I'm a country lawyer. I'd be honored to represent you in your case. I'll treat you right. I'll do the best I can to help you.
say if it tastes good, it can't be good for you. We beg to differ. Now open New Day Nutrition in the Weddington Plaza, Pikeville. Your home for delicious, healthy, energy-boosting teas, specialty iced and hot coffees, and scrumptious protein shakes that serve as a meal replacement. Try our protein bars or tasty protein coffees. And coming soon, baked goods. Open Monday through Friday, 7 till 6. Saturday, 9 till 5. Curbside service and delivery are available. Call 637-2120 or visit newdaynutritioncenter.com.
Back here at Floyd Central, we're about a minute to go before the start of the second half. 30-22, Magoffin County on top, and the winner will be the regional champion, Section 8, Kentucky 2A State Championship.
And they'll be playing Mason County, who's 13-2. They're Section 6 champions. That game will be on January the 13th at 9 p.m. That's Central Time, be 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That's going to be at the Owensboro Sports Center, and it's the final game of the night.
That's a long trip down there to play that late as well. So
yes.
Definitely going to have to get a room down there late.
Not going to make that trip back that night.
No.
Looks like Magoffin County is going to have it to start this third quarter as clock winding down to zero, and we'll get started here shortly.
See what kind of...
We was informed by Jason Blanton, radio personnel down in Johnson County, that this was only the fourth time in the history of Magoffin County High School, as far as the boys, that they will have a chance to win a regional championship. They've got the eight-point lead as we get started here in the second half.
It's like a change of defense here, like a 1-2-2, little trap.
And there's the baseline jumper, Grayson Whitaker, no good. Pike Central with it, Rigdon in the corner, Stewart, wide open, three, comes up short.
They dodged a bullet there. He's not going to miss a bunch of those.
Not going to miss that many of them. And here on the other end, Barnett tries to take it down the lane, loses control of it off of one of his teammates' feet and out of bounds.
Kind of went right off of Whitaker's foot. I don't know if he lost it or if he tried to pass it, but it was hit his foot straight out of bounds.
Pike Central working in the front court with it now. That's Adams with it. On top. Gets it over to Reynolds. They try to go downside to Stewart. He goes down to the floor, and Goffin kind of comes up with a steal.
I didn't see what happened.
Goffin County with it. Barnett
thought it was a foul, but I didn't see.
There's Whitaker, Barnett. Long pass cross court to Whitaker, and here's the steal. Rigdon got his hands on it, and then they're going to be the foul, and it's going to be before the shot. Salyer will pick that one up.
Good foul, though.
His second foul. Stewart comes into Rigdon. Into the corner, it goes back to Rigdon.
Yeah, that was a for sure two there. Now going to have to make them earn it.
Into the corner to go. Adams with the three. Yes.
Wow.
And he's fouled. Woo. Barnett with the foul.
Be a Barnett second. Adams, that'll be his second three.
And that gets the Hawks crazies, I guess we can call them, fired up over here in the corner.
The Hawks nest has transported Floyd County.
Blake Adams trying to complete the four-point play, and killed it on the heel of the rim, and it falls
died.
Through.
It died, didn't have anywhere to go but straight through the net.
So he cuts the lead in half,
30-26.
Barnett on the other end. Sayer out to Barnett. He's going to fire the three, and
Rigdon
with the partial block, but Sayerville comes up with it, and then we got a foul on the other side.
Same situation.
And it's going to be a 3-point shot.
Except Whitaker didn't make his, but on number one,
Grayson Whitaker.
12, okay,
number
Reynolds.
12, yeah, yeah. Reynolds. So Whitaker. Grayson Whitaker will go to the line shooting three free throws. Makes the first.
Yeah, people flying at the
81% free throw shooting.
Yeah.
13 of 16.
That's it looks pretty good. I mean, he's you can tell he's a good shooter.
And the second one's also good.
Good rotation.
You have got some the flying, third one now.
People at the three-point line here. You've got the two fouls, and Rigdon got the block.
Right.
So a good pump fake might go a long way here.
A lot of action out at the arc.
Yeah.
And misses the third free throw, so he goes 2 of 3, and his team's got the six-point lead, 32-26. Rigdon works in the front court with it. Running the weave at the top of the circle. Here's Stewart. Down the left side, he takes the baseline now, reverses, ooh, puts it up and in.
Good move. Nice looking move.
A little crossover dribble. Yeah. Was able to get around his man. It's a four-point lead, 32-28. And here's the pass deflected, but Barnett comes up with it. Gives it over to Zane Whitaker. Back to Barnett. Fires up the three. No. Rigdon runs the long rebound down. He's on the move. And down the court he goes. And it's going to be a foul before the shot. And another foul on Salyer. And that's going to be his third.
His third.
He was able to keep Rigdon in check in that first half. But Rigdon's come out second half and really
put the pressure on him.
Yeah, he's been aggressive, taking it to the bucket.
Yeah, Rigdon with no points, but he's drawn two fouls. And, you know, if you can get Salyer, pick up another foul here in the third, put some big-time pressure on him.
Here's Stewart in the lane.
Good
to get it down low. Ball knocked loose, picked up by Magoffin County.
Good idea. He was open,
but
he just couldn't get the pass there.
Grayson Whitaker with it. Goes to Zane Whitaker. He's double-teamed and near steal. Barnett fires up the three short. Zane Whitaker with the rebound, puts it on the floor. As it knocked loose, comes up with it. Grayson Whitaker, no. And Stewart comes off with the rebound. Goffin County had their chances that time, just couldn't get it to fall. And here in the corner, Adams, three, count it.
He's played big.
Blake Adams. And hits a one-point game, 32-31, Magoffin County. 32nd timeout by Magoffin County. 4:08 left third quarter, and we've got a game.
Magoffin County with only 2 points in the quarter, those two free throws. So they've got no field goals. You're almost halfway through. And, you know, Pike Central, Blake Adams has got 6, Jaden Stewart with 8. So, I mean, this is
Adams has got 7.
Or, he hit the free throw, got the four-point play.
He got the four-point play.
Yeah, yeah. So,
and that's just 7 in the quarter. He's got, that makes him 12 for the game.
Yeah,
he's their leading scorer right now.
Yeah, and he's only averaging, I think, 3.8 points a game. So, that's the kind of lift you need. You know, Rigdon with 6 and Stewart with 7.
Adams, 3.4 points a game.
Yeah, I mean, that's
got 12 right now.
So he's 4 times his average already.
He is.
He's still got a quarter and a half to go. And he's playing with confidence, too. He's shooting that ball.
No hesitation right now. He's rim's looking big to him right now. And here's a 3 out of the corner. No good. Pike Central comes off the rebound, and it's Adams with the rebound.
Got a chance to take the lead.
Yes. Here's a drive to the bucket, and the shot.
Oof, that's on
no
Barnett.
Good. And that's Barnett going to pick up the foul.
It on 5. Caught it on Whitaker.
Got Whitaker.
Just his first.
Barnett took the brunt of the action, though.
He did.
He's checking his lip right now.
Yeah.
And that's Peyton Compton at the line. He'll have 2 free throws. He ties it with the first. All even at 32.
He split a pair in the first half.
He can give his team the lead and does, and that's the first lead for Pike Central from way back early in the game.
Oh, absolutely. Maybe 2-0, because you remember it was, they yeah. jumped out all over them.
And here's a steal. Rigdon going to go against Barnett, and Barnett with the two fouls just let it go, but then on the other end, Lafferty, and he puts it up and in.
Might have shuffled them feet a little bit when he got there.
Here's Rigdon into the front court. 35-34, Pike Central, they have the basketball. 3:10 left here, third quarter.
Oof.
Adams, three, yes.
What a game, what a.
And you got to give credit to Rigdon for realizing that he's got the hot hand right now.
Yeah, that's his third three-pointer of the quarter.
And there's Whitaker down low, puts it up and in. Zane Whitaker got down on that low block. He's tough to handle down there.
Just his first bucket here in the second half.
38-36, Pike Central leads by two. They have the basketball.
Got some good action going on right now, both sides of the ball.
2:30 left here, third quarter. Rigdon just inside the three-point line, no. And Stewart come up the rebound, gets it out. Compton three. Oh,
rims
halfway
out.
Down and back out.
Yeah.
Barnett on the other end shot no good. Rigdon comes off with it. Two on two. Adams fires up the three, comes up short. Didn't get his feet set that time. Barnett and one. Wow, what a shot by Barnett.
Yes, off balance. Number
throws
two.
It up off the glass. Foul goes that. Against Compton.
That's a crazy finish. His one-legged falling away.
Yes, I'm telling you. But we've seen him make shots like that before.
Yeah.
Knocks the free throw down, completes the three-point play. It's back to a one-point lead in Magoffin County. Coach Eric Rattler not happy with that call.
No. Kind of a bailout call, but there was a lot of contact, so I don't know how you don't call it.
Here's Adams. Faked the three, put it on the floor, had it knocked loose from behind. Magoffin County has it. Barnett down the lane, out. Whitaker, three, no. Tipped out of bounds. It's going to go to Pike Central. And Adams comes off holding his face. I think he took a shot in the nose.
Yeah, I think when Barnett kind of poked that ball away, I think his hand came up.
1:24 left, third quarter, to 39-38, Magoffin County. Pike Central with the basketball. Rigdon into the front court. Gets a screen, gets a step down the baseline. Kicks it back out and try to get it over to Owens, and pass was kicked. It's going to stay with Pike Central. 106, third quarter.
Stewart's not got any good looks here since he took that one baseline there.
Yes. Here's Rigdon driving, kicks it out.
There Compton. He is.
Stewart hands back to Rigdon, gets back out, going to reset the offense. 50 seconds to go here, third quarter. Pike Central down eight at the half. They're down one. They've had the lead at one time here in this third quarter. And here's Rigdon down the lane. Shot up, no good.
Whitaker
with the influence, that shot, and then comes down with the rebound.
Yeah.
And here, drive to the bucket, shot up, misses it. But Whitaker tips it out. Barnett, three, no. 18 seconds left. Stewart with it in the front court.
Got a hold for one here.
Yes.
Nothing but a layup.
We're at 7 seconds. Rigdon's got looking for a screen. Over. Shot up at the horn. No. And at the end of three, 39-38, Magoffin County. Don't go away, folks. This one's going down to the final shot. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
Essentials. Higher costs impact Gearheart broadband's rates, but our services keep getting better. TV can cost less than before, and our internet is faster than ever. Gearheart broadband, great value for our community.
I'm Jennifer Reynolds, and I've been a state farm agent for over 20 years here in Pike. We offer all the products and services available through State Farm Insurance. You'll receive all the benefits of a state farm agent in a convenient location while being serviced by my licensed staff in a friendly office environment. Call us if you need a quote for auto insurance, fire, life, or health, or if you need information on our financial services product. Our commitment is to you, our client. Walk in, call in, or click in anytime, day or night.
This changes everything. Gearheart TV is available now. It's the digital TV service delivered to your smart TV or connected devices by Gearheart Broadband. Sign up now at mygtv.com.
Back here at Floyd Central, Magoffin County hanging on, 39-38. Had an 8-point lead at the half, and Pike Central outscores them 16-9 to cut it down to one, and they took the lead.
And, they did, yes.
Just going to be a back-and-forth affair here. I think we're in for a good one, Larry.
Stafford for Pike Central brings it in, and Rigdon has it.
Yeah, Adam's still on the bench here. I'm sure that's not going to last very long here.
He had the hot hand in that quarter.
Yeah, had 10 of the 16.
There's Stafford with it. Fakes the shot, gives it to Rigdon down the lane. Gets Whitaker. Shot up, no good. Rebound put up, no good. Zane Whitaker goes up and claims the rebound this time for Magoffin County.
Yeah, Whitaker just changes so much down there. He doesn't get a block, but he changed that shot.
And here he has it at the free throw line. Jumper up, way off.
Ooh,
rebound.
Big rebound.
Put back up and in. Russell Walker. Excuse me, Walker Russell.
Yeah.
Got him back.
That's a big offensive rebound right there.
Wow. Magoffin County back for three. Here's Stewart with the three. No good. Battle for the rebound on the floor. And we're going to have a tie-up. Here it will go to Magoffin County. Isaac Reynolds returning to the lineup for the Hawks. .708. Barnett into the front court to Grayson Whitaker.
The pass.
And inside, that's Lafferty. Ooh. And Stewart comes up with the block.
Big block.
On the other end, Compton to the bucket, and he's blocked as he tries to reverse. But Pike Central was able to come out with it in the corner. Stewart, three, yes. Ooh. We're tied at 41.
Big shot. Offensive rebounds.
He didn't have to think about that, and he just got it and fired it.
Yeah. Which he had Zane Whitaker running at him. You better get it off quick.
Yeah, it's it. Here's Lafferty with it down low. Turn around in the lane. No good. Whitaker tried to put it up. No good. And I think that was Grayson Whitaker with the
bucket. So.
Number five.
Yeah, I think Zane got his hand on it.
Right.
And Grayson was the finisher.
Pike Central working in the front court now. And beautiful back cut by Rigdon, and he misses it, but he's going to be fouled. That's going to go against Zane Whitaker.
Usually, you go to that other side and get that protection, but I think he'd been better off going on this on the left-hand side on that one.
Right, going up on the side that he was breaking in on.
Yeah. So two.
And that's the first foul on Whitaker.
Yeah.
Rigdon at the line for two. Rose the first one in off the front of the rim.
Pretty impressive by Whitaker. As many shots as he's blocked and changed to only pick up your first foul with 6 minutes to go in the game.
Yes. Rigdon can tie it with this one. It's 43-42. Clock stopped 5:59 left in the ball game, and Rigdon ties it at 43. two evenly matched teams here.
Yeah, just a little 2-2-1 half court. Don't see a lot of that.
No.
Oh,
and
man.
And there's a steal. Rigdon. And ooh. Barnett goes up, knocks it out of bounds, but he's going to be called with the body.
Ooh. I don't know.
And is that his third?
Yes. Yeah, that's a big one. I'm not 100% sure. I didn't have a good angle.
Earlier in the third quarter, you had the same situation.
And
he just let Rigdon go. That time he decided to challenge him. Got the block as far as up on top, but they said he got him with the body. And Rigdon gives his team the one-point lead.
And, you know, both officials called the foul, too. So,
yes. Our old buddy Jonathan Parsons watching in. He's seeing a good one.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Red knows good basketball.
And Rigdon, 4-of-4 in this quarter from the line, gives his team the two-point lead, 45-43.
They're 10-for-11 from the free throw line.
Pretty high percentage.
Yes. That'll win the game for you. I mean, you know.
These close games, most definitely will. And Magoffin County is wanting a timeout. It's going to be a full 5:25 left in the ball game. Pike Central by 2. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
Howard Family Pharmacy offers fast and friendly service and drive-throughs at both locations at the intersection in Allen and off Route 80 at Eastern.
Gearheart Security's Smart Home Holiday Bundles are here. Combine blazing fast broadband and home security to save some cash, plus a free security camera. We also offer home security takeovers, life sentry, camera-only specials with financing available. Find out more at gearheartsecurity.com/specials or call us at 1-800-264-1730. Stop by our new location in Harrell to enter to win a free Yeti cooler.
Any home can be improved with better Wi-Fi. That's why Gearheart Broadband offers Plume Wi-Fi, a reliable signal throughout your home, enhanced by mobile app features. Call or click Gearheart Broadband to learn more.
5:25 to go. Pike Central on top, 45-43. Magoffin County to inbound the ball. Looks like they're staying in that zone there a little.
Well, they got a steal out of the last trip down.
Yeah, with Rigdon out front there, you better throw a good pass or he's going to get a hand.
Yeah, you can't lob it around.
No.
Here's Barnett down in the middle, and
good.
I think he was trying to pass it to start with, but Lafferty come up with a loose ball and ties it at 45.
Yeah, that's that using the rim to protect yourself. Oh, Magoffin County with a little zone.
Yeah, a little half-court trap also.
The only bad thing about a zone with Stewart is he'll make you pay.
Yes.
And Adams back in the game as well, so.
Got two good three-point shooters right now. Here's Adams with it. Rigdon.
Oh, man, he had him earlier.
And Stewart, long three, no.
Wow.
And high up for the rebound. That was Peyton Compton, and he's fouled. he was above the rim on that one.
He was way up there on that one.
And who the foul's on?
Whitaker, his second on Zane Whitaker.
And that's going to be the 1-on-1, Justin. That's 17 foul from Magoffin County. Pike Central with only 2.
Yeah, that's the reverse of the first half because, they were in the bonus in the first half, Magoffin County.
Compton at the line, 1-on-1, and misses it. Boy, he's critical now.
Yeah, everything's big. Everything's amplified now.
With the two team fouls, that gives Pike Central the chance to be more aggressive.
Yeah.
And if they get a foul, not going to send them to the line. There's Barnett. And I think Stewart's going to pick up his third.
So that'll be Barnett.
Magoffin County has made an adjustment, too, Justin. If you notice, they put, since Pike Central's went to that half-court pressure, they put Barnett at the foul line.
Right.
And once they get it past those two in the front, then he's working down in
work.
The lane.
Yeah, it gives him a better position. If you can get him the ball in there, anytime you can get in the middle of the zone, you're going to cause some trouble. And you obviously want, if you can get your best player the ball in the middle of the zone. It's
yes. And he makes them both. Gives his team the two-point lead, 47-45. And here's a steal. And it's stolen back by Stewart. Rigdon driving the lane, looking for help. Stewart, wide open three. No. And another rebound, Pike Central. That was number 12, Reynolds, with it. Rigdon looking for help.
Oh, he's got him underneath.
Over in the corner. And hits the support cable on top of the backboard. So it will go to Magoffin County. Pike Central wanting a timeout. It's going to be a 30.
It's our first timeout of the game with 3:47 to go.
47-45, as Justin said, 3:47 to go.
If you're Pike Central here, you got to turn up the defense a little bit. I mean, they've played really good defense, but you in a close game like this, you only got three fouls. You don't want to get to the end of the game with three fouls, and then you can't put them at the free throw line.
Yes.
So you kind of want to mention maybe you can be just a little bit more aggressive here.
Exactly. Go for the steal or whatever.
Yeah, go work somebody a little bit harder on the offensive glass and give yourself a shot.
And on the for Magoffin County, since they went to the half-court pressure, it's got Pike Central out of their offense now. They're scrambling on offense on their offensive end.
Yeah, credit Coach Castle there. They were down, I think, four when he called that timeout, and they had the ball.
Yeah.
And they scored, and then they got in this zone, and it's, you know, now they're back up by two. So, great move by Coach Castle.
Magoffin County has it. They're into the front court with it. Grayson Whitaker. Sayer back in the lineup. He's got the three fouls. And here is Grayson Whitaker. Shot no good.
That's a good shot, though.
Stewart clears the board for Pike Central. Rigdon up to Stewart.
Yeah, that.
He's getting double teamed, looking for some help. Compton drives on the baseline and throws it away. And Whitaker goes in, puts it up and in. And Magoffin County before.
Yeah, that zone, that Pike Central has not figured it out yet.
No.
And it's keeping Rigdon out of the lane. Might have got away with one there.
It is. Well, they're trying to dribble through it, and you got to use the pass.
Yeah. Good pass.
And ours a good pass, and put up and in by Rigdon.
That's how you do it.
Got to have that help. Somebody, if it's somebody double-teaming, somebody's open, they got to break to the bucket, present herself. 49-47, 2:30 left. Lafferty with it.
Oh, man, you got to.
And foul on Pike Central, which no harm done. That's only four team fouls.
If you're Adams, though, that was a pretty easy pass to get in there. And him standing there, you could be aggressive and try to
pick that one off.
Yeah, poke that out somehow.
Comes into Barnett on Rigby. Long shot. Whitaker, no. Rebound comes off Peyton Compton. His team trails by two, 49-47. We're at 2 minutes to go. And we're going to get a foul. That's going to go against Grayson Whitaker.
I thought there's a lot of ball on that one.
And that will be the 1-1. I think Compton missed the last one.
He missed the front end.
Front end of the 1-1.
Yep, he sure did.
2:05 left. 2-point game. Compton could tie it with both free throws. And he misses it.
That's crucial. Got to have
that. That's two front ends of the 1-1 that Pike Central's missed, and they trail by two.
Yep. Got to have them. Salyer's not been in the game. He got the timeout.
And got the timeout. Saved him there.
Yep.
It's going to be a 30-second timeout. 1:50 left. Magoffin County with the basketball and the two-point lead. Pike Central with only four team fouls, so they can be aggressive on the defensive end.
Yeah, that
timeout. Each team got plenty as far as the timeouts go.
Yeah, you're Pike Central. You got to dial it up here, but you can't be so aggressive that you give yourself give them a back cut or give them an opportunity to get a layup.
Possession arrow. If I'm looking at the scoreboard right, it's going to Pike Central.
Yeah. Yeah, that. You know, you can go pick up that fifth foul by going for that jump ball. You know, if Barnett gets it at the free throw line, just go in and see if you can take it. I don't know if there's very many in the region that's strong enough to just take it.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? You can go for the jump ball, though.
Whitaker down in the corner. That's Zane back to Grayson.
Yeah, that's and not how
Stewart
you want to get it.
Picked it up, and he's the man you don't want to pick it up. That's four on him now.
Yep. Yeah, that's not how you want to get that foul.
Five team fouls now. They've still got one more to give. And Grayson Whitaker turns around and knocks down the three-point shot.
He's
huge
got seven.
Shot.
He's got seven this quarter. Yeah, this zone is really frustrated Pike Central.
Here it comes crossover to Stewart down in the corner. That's Adams. Here's Rigdon down the lane to the bucket up. No good. Stewart battling for the rebound. Comes up with it. Knocked loose. Still battling for it. Puts it up. No good. Ball on the floor again and got a foul. That's going to go against Arnett. Or Barnett, excuse me.
Bodies everywhere. Bodies everywhere. How do you clean that up? Got to be four on Barnett, so.
And who they're going to send to the line?
Yeah, really. I'm not sure who was on the bottom of that. I know 12.
Reynolds was in there, but I think it was another Pike Central player. And
yeah, I think that's who it is, Blake Adams.
Adams, and he's got a little limp going, but he's going into the foul line. And this will be the 1-1 again. They missed the front end of the last two. 52-47. And again, if Pike Central ends up losing this one, just look at the foul line.
Yep. You got a foul right here. You got to be aggressive. Yep.
52-47. Barnett to the goal and fouled by Stewart, and that's going to be all for Stewart.
Yep.
Oh, they called 12 over there.
Yeah.
Okay. Reynolds. I know Stewart was on top of Barnett out of bounds, so.
Somehow avoided the foul there.
Officials got dyslexia.
Yeah. That's right.
Barnett.
And like you said.
Two possession game. Like this would make it three possession game, and it would be a long way for Pike Central to come back.
The only good thing is Pike Central's got four timeouts, so they can stop the clock anytime they score.
And Barnett, he makes both his free throws. Pike Central is 0-3 on 3 1-on-1s. Whitaker with the block. Barnett with it. Down it goes to Lafferty. And that's going to do it, folks.
That'll do it.
56-47, 9-point lead. Stewart, long three, no. Whitaker comes down with it. That's Grayson Whitaker, and he's fouled. 27 seconds left, and Magoffin County is going to get that elusive 15th region championship here in the Class 2A. Well, it's not the 15th region. It will be the Section 8.
Yeah, the Section 8, yeah. This will give Magoffin County a lot of tournament experience when it comes to the end of the year as well.
And free throw's no good. 56-47. Here's Rigdon kicking it over. Compton three, yes. And Pike Central calls the timeout. 16 seconds, all that's left. It's 56-50. Magoffin County. It's a full timeout. Let's stay right here with it, Justin. Both teams now, well, Magoffin County would put Pike Central with a foul in the double bonus. They've got 19 fouls. 17 fouls for Pike Central, so it's a 1-1, and that's what you expect to see Pike Central do if they don't come up to steal.
You've got to have
an immediate foul.
Yes. You either get the steal or you foul immediately, no matter who it is. And you've got a sliver of hope if they miss the front end. And,
yeah,
that, you know, you are in the 1-1.
Or if
so,
you come up with a steal,
yeah,
knock down a three-point,
yeah,
shot.
But it's got to be all three-pointers at this point.
Yes.
You know, credit Magoffin County. I mean, they've made the plays down the stretch here. They've been tough and got those rebounds. You know, Lafferty hitting that layup there, that was pretty big.
Yes.
I kind of thought he should have dribbled it out, but after you know, that's the no, 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 yes, 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 after it goes in. But, you know, the free throw line here in the fourth quarter for Pike Central, 3 1-1s.
Missed the front end of 3 1-1s. They're not guarding the man taking the ball out of bounds, and they're going to throw it long.
Oh, man. Wow.
Barnett.
What a catch.
Nope. Caught him for the walk.
How he ran that down, I don't know. That was a should be down here, too.
No, he caught it in bounds.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, he got the walk. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, stumbled on his way to the basket there. Got to go fast here.
They steal some hope for Pike Central. Rigdon with it.
Got to shoot the three. We're going for it.
And caught him for the charge. And what we have here, Rigdon.
He bumped him.
Rigdon went to the floor.
Yeah, I think Salyers gave him a little bump. They're going to call the tee, I think.
And they're still trying to get them separated.
I think if you come in blowing the whistle, you got to call the tee.
Yeah.
I mean, if you saw it.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw
it. I mean,
it.
You know, he obviously saw the bump. So we got the charge on Rigdon. Wow, that'd just be his first team foul or his first foul of the night. This is crucial, though, because you could get two free throws.
And the ball.
And the ball. Still trying to sort it out a little bit.
They're going to call the foul on Rigdon, charge. And I don't
That's
think
it?
They called it technical.
Yeah, I think he did. I've not seen him give the call, but the explanation to Coach Castle here, yeah, right there it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Technical.
I could see Coach Castle's reaction. They definitely got the technical. So two free throws in the ball.
So it's 10.5 seconds left.
Four.
They can cut it to four with the two free throws. And then they'll have the basketball after the foul shots. And Rigdon makes the first. Not a very smart move by the Magoffin County players.
No. And I saw him kind of give him that bump there.
Yes. Yeah. Emotions get caught up in the emotions sometimes and hurt your team.
Can you call a timeout during the middle of a technical free throw?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's going to be a full, so let's take one ourselves. 10 seconds left. It's a four-point game. Rigdon be at the line for one when we return. It's your Mountain Sports Network.
You plan on being there for her for a long, long time. For recitals. Soccer games. Graduations. Until she's a grown-up of her own. But what if you can't be there? Protect what matters most. Talk to a Kentucky Farm Bureau agent about life insurance.
Come push me, Daddy.
Talk to agent John Greer Hunt today at 606-791-2122.
They say if it tastes good, it can't be good for you. We beg to differ. Now open Newday Nutrition in the Weddington Plaza, Pikeville. Your home for delicious, healthy, energy-boosting teas, specialty iced and hot coffees, and scrumptious protein shakes that serve as a meal replacement. Try our protein bars or tasty protein coffees. And coming soon, baked goods. Open Monday through Friday, 7 till...
And we're back at Floyd Central. 10.5 seconds left. 56-51. Rigdon at the line for Pike Central, shooting the second technical. Makes it. 4-point game. And Pike Central out of the basketball. And they go to Rigdon. Got to go fast. He's going to take it to the bucket. Shot up and in. And Pike Central calls the timeout. 3.9 seconds. And let's see, I think they're going to put some more time on the clock. Got 3.9, but I think the official said 5 seconds.
Right.
Two-point game. And let's see if they change the time on the clock. And they put 4.3 back up. Magoffin County, Ohio Abbott, bring his length of floor. Pike Central with 18 fouls. It'll be the 1-1 if they can't get the steal. But if they get the steal and the two-point bucket, we're tied, or a three-pointer would win it.
Yeah, this is, what a change. I mean, it was over.
It was over.
It was over.
Yes, I'll agree with you 100%.
And they basically, got a charge, and they have gifted Pike Central 4 straight points after you had the ball, because the charge would have gave them possession.
Right,
and you've gifted them 4 points. So.
Yeah, I might have called that a little earlier when Barnett made that, when that put them up 9 points.
Yes, yeah.
Or, excuse me, not Barnett, but Lafferty on the layup.
Yeah.
So here we go. Barnett will step out of bounds, and Pike Central's not guarding the inbounder, and he'll come in. And that's going to be
foul
for Stewart. And that's going to put Zane Whitaker. But, you know, you can't worry about how many fouls you got now in that situation. You just got to get a foul as soon as you can.
Yeah, whoever inbounds the ball, but my thought process would Stewart would have probably been set. You know what I mean? Because, you know. But, you know, that's the kind of decisions you got to make. But if
you get the foul, then you can re-enter him
offense,
into the
defense,
game.
Offense, yeah. But, you know, you're kind of banking on maybe you get that steal and you kind of want
What's
him in
Whitaker
the game.
What's Whitaker done at the line tonight, Zane Whitaker?
He is 3-for-3.
It's 1-1.
What are they doing?
It's the 1-1.
That should have been the 1-1. What? That's the 1-1.
Well, it's the 1-1.
No, it's, well. Better blow the whistle. That's a 1-1.
That's a 1-1.
Yeah. I mean,
now what you do?
It's got to be the possession, and it's the possession goes Pike Central.
Pike Central.
Oh, my God. I wondered why nobody was moving.
Yeah. The officials told him 2 shots, but it's 1-1. And now Magoffin County coach all upset.
Yeah, he's saying that they said 2 fouls or 2 shots.
Well, they did say 2 shots, but you got to give
it. It's the
that's got to go to the official score.
Yeah, and
he's got to make sure that they know it's the 1-1. Wow, what an ending to this one! And it ain't over yet.
No, and how is it not over? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
With 20 seconds to go. Lafferty makes a layup and puts them up. I think that was it
eight?
8 points.
Yes. And they're going to the scorebook.
Yeah, that's not the scorebook.
But now, that's not the official scorebook.
No.
They've had it on the clock. You know, we called it ourselves. They had 8 fouls. He misses the free throw. Pike Central, everybody's standing there. Nobody goes for the rebound. If this goes to the possession arrow, it favors Pike Central.
I don't know how.
Be interesting to see what the official decides.
Because you can't let him shoot another one.
No.
I mean, you can't.
I don't see how you could.
And if you somehow go to, this game's been so crazy, but if you get into overtime, Stewart's on the bench.
Yeah.
That's crucial.
Of course, you got Adam and you got Rigdon.
Yeah.
But can you get to the bucket from one end to the other in 3 seconds?
Well, they're spending a lot of time on the Magoffin County end of the floor here. Pike Central coach doesn't seem to be,
Pike Central ball?
Yeah. Jump ball. There you go. That's what I thought. I thought that was the only solution that you could have at this point.
And Pike Central is going to call a timeout.
Yeah, for sure.
I've never seen that before at the end of the game.
No.
When the game was on the line.
No. And I don't know. I just don't know how you're not. Obviously, the players didn't know. I just don't know how you don't know that situation. You know what I mean? Like, I keep my own book up here.
You know, the officials needs to know that, but the official scorer is also a game official.
Yes.
And he needs to let them know for sure.
What's going on.
If he's seen them give the two shots, he should blow the horn.
Right, and let them know.
And correct it. So he's as much...
I think, in fault as the
officials.
Yeah, I think the scorekeeper, because Coach Castle was pretty upset that because he was saying that you told him two, so I could kind of read his lips. If they hit a three here, this place might go up in flames tonight.
Magoffin
County might be on fire.
Where's the law enforcement at? Here's Rigdon. Three in the air. No!
Oh, man.
Off the heel of the rim, and Magoffin County holds on.
Oh, man. That was right on target, too.
56-54. Rigdon had an open three and just a little bit long. And Magoffin County, the Section 8 Class 2A champions.
Wow. What a finish.
We'll send it back to the station and be back shortly this year in the Mountain Sports Network.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Howard Family Pharmacy offers fast and friendly service and drive-thrus at both locations at the intersection in Allen and off Route 80 at Eastern.
This changes everything. Gearheart TV is available now. It's the digital TV service delivered to your smart TV or connected devices by Gearheart Broadband. Sign up now at mygtv.com.
I'm Jennifer Reynolds, and I've been a State Farm agent for over 20 years here in Pikeville. We offer all the products and services available through State Farm Insurance. You'll receive all the benefits of a State Farm agent in a convenient location while being serviced by my licensed staff in a friendly office environment. Call us if you need a quote for auto insurance, fire, life, or health, or if you need information on our financial services product. Our commitment is to you, our client. Walk in, call in, or click in anytime, day or night.
What a game, folks. 56-54. A little bit of controversy right at the end of the game as
a little bit.
The officials getting to 1-1 and giving Pike Central a chance to pull it out. Rigdon comes up a little long on the three-point shot at the horn. Magoffin County hangs on and getting ready for the trophy presentation. And while we're doing that, Justin, give us some numbers.
For Magoffin County, 17 points for Barnett, 13 for Zane Whitaker, 8 for Ben Lafferty, 14 for Grayson Whitaker, 2 for Walker Russell, and 2 for Ethan Salyer, 2 for Reed Meadows. They were 14 for 19 from the free throw line. They were 6 for 7 in the fourth quarter. For Pike Central, 14 points for Rigdon, 10 for Stewart, 9 for Peyton Compton, 15 for Blake Adams, and 2 for Isaac Reynolds, and they were 10 for 14 from the free throw line, and only 4 for 7 in the fourth quarter, and the 3 misses were the bonus.
Class 2A Section A runner-up trophy, Pike County Central.
What a game, what a finish, but those 3 bonus, you know.
Yeah, you get beat 2 points, and you had missed the front end of 3 one-on-ones.
For 7. They were 10 for 14 from the free throw line. And 3 front end of the bonus.
Yeah, missed and 3 that, front ends of bonus, then you end up getting beat by 2. Of course,
credit Magoffin County, you know, for coming through and making enough plays to win the game. Kind of almost a gift.
Yeah.
You know, if that 3 from Rigdon goes down, that might be one of the biggest blown leads I've ever seen in my life to blow one that fast in that fashion.
Well, and the technical on the player for after the charge on Rigdon, and then Magoffin County's player getting the technical on him, and it put his team in that situation.
Yes, absolutely.
So that's going to wrap it up here for us tonight. Before we go off the air, let you know that we'll be back on the air tomorrow night coming from tomorrow evening. 2:30 coming from the Appalachian Wireless Arena. It will be the girls' 15th region All-A championship game, and that game will feature Pikeville and Martin County. So we encourage you to come out and support your teams. If you're not able to do that, tune in to WPRG TV and Intermountain Sports. We'll be there to cover all the action. So for my partner, Justin Holbrook, for Alex back to station, Wayne Figgard on camera, Larry Cecil saying so long and good night. 56-54, Magoffin County with the Section 8 Class 2A Championship. This is the Intermountain Sports Network.